Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on my YouTube channel. You can watch various programming related videos here. My channel contains more than 800 videos. You can search those videos through the keyword programming by Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the implementation of strlen function as predefined and as user defined. So first I am going to implement strlen function as predefined variation. So I am going to include two header files. First is stdio.h and second one is string.h. Now I am going to declare a character array and I have initialized a value in it, that is my name. Then I have declared a variable of integer type, that is len. Now I am going to call strlen function, which is predefined. So it will calculate length of the string and the result will be stored inside len variable. So I can print that on output screen with the help of printf. So this way I have implemented strlen as predefined. Now I am going to execute this. So you can see the output, it is showing length equals to 6. So strlen function basically find out how many characters are available in a string. It doesn't include null character, that is represented by \0. So before \0, the characters which are available in the string, that is counted through this function. So this was the implementation of strlen function as predefined. Now I am going to convert it and I am going to implement this strlen function working as user defined function. So first I have declared a function whose name is xstrlen. I can't use strlen because it is already defined. So I have modified this name as xstrlen. This function will receive an argument of character array type and it will return an integer as output. Here I have to call this function at line number 8. Remaining code will be same. After defining main function, I have to implement definition of xstrlen. So here I have to implement the logic so that I can find out how many characters are available in string str. So here I have declared two variables, len, which is initialized with 0, and then I. Both are of integer type. So here I have implemented a loop which will count how many characters are available before \0 in the string. And calculated value will be available in len variable. After completion of this loop, I can return this variable and the returned value will be stored inside len variable, which is available at line number 8. So this way I have implemented the user defined version of strlen function. So here no need of including string.h header file because I have created the definition or the process for counting how many characters are available in the string. So this way I have implemented the code. Now I am going to execute this so that you can check whether it is working or not, properly or not. So it is printing the result as length equals to 6, which is correct. So friends, this way I have converted a predefined function process into user defined function. I hope you have understood both the implementation, and you might have understood the difference between predefined and user-defined implementation of strlen function. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.